Hello everyone, this is Mohan Kumar. Today I shall be talking about structure and function of endoplasmic reticulum. So as you know, within the cytoplasm of most animal cells is an extensive network or reticulum of membrane limited channels. They are collectively called as endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is a name which is derived from the fact that in the light microscope it looks like a net of cytoplasm. So as you can see in the picture, it is more like a net in the cytoplasm. So the endoplasmic reticulum is the only organelle present in the eukaryotic cell. So it is found only in eukaryotic cells and not prokaryotes. So however, the occurrence of endoplasmic reticulum varies from cell to cell within eukaryotes. For example, in erythrocytes, egg and embryonic cells, they do not have endoplasmic reticulum. However, other cells like epithelial cells of the intestine, they would have endoplasmic reticulum. Or brain cells, they would have endoplasmic reticulum. Or kidney cells, liver cells, hepatocytes, pancreatohepatic cells, everything, all the cells will have endoplasmic reticulum, leaving RBCs, egg and embryonic cells. Some portion of the endoplasmic reticular membranes remain continuous with the plasma membrane and the nuclear envelope. As you can see in this picture, it would begin from the nuclear envelope and would end in the plasma membrane, which is not shown in this picture, however. So here may be rough or smooth. We shall discuss both. The outer surface of the rough endoplasmic reticulum has attached ribosomes, as you can see in this picture, whereas the smooth endoplasmic reticulum does not have attached ribosomes. The endoplasmic reticulum acts as a secretory, storage, circulatory and nervous system for the cell. So it plays multiple roles. It is also the site of biogenesis of cellular membranes. The membranes of the endoplasmic reticulum is around 50 to 60 angstrom in thickness. And fluid mosaic like, as you can see in this picture, it is almost like plasma membrane unit itself, as they secrete out plasma membranes as one of their function. The membranes of the endoplasmic reticulum are found to contain many kind of enzymes that are needed for various important synthetic activities. The most important enzymes are stearases, NADH cytochrome C reductases, NADH diaphorase, glucose 6 phosphatase and magnesium activated ATPases. The membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum remains continuous with the membranes of the plasma membrane or nuclear membrane and Golgi apparatus. The cavity of the endoplasmic reticulum is well developed and acts as a passage for the secretory products. These are the cavities we see, and so they act as a passage for secretory products. So they occur in three forms: lamellar form, that is cisternae, vesicular form or vesicles, or tubular form or tubules. So the cisternae, the lamellar form, see the cisternae or the cisterna, which is singular, cisternae is a series of flattened curved membrane sacs, as you can see here. So this curved membrane saccules of endoplasmic reticulum forms the cisternae. So the rough endoplasmic reticulum usually exist, these one exist as cisternae that occur in those cells which have synthetic roles, as the cells of the pancreas, notochord and brain. These are the examples. The cistern A, the unbranched tubules of the cistern A have a diameter of around 40 to 50 micrometer, and they remain arranged parallelly in bundles, as you can see here, or in stakes. The vesicles, second one, the vesicles are oval, membrane-bound, vascular structures having a diameter of 25 to 500 micrometer, which is much larger than the cistern. So they often remain isolated in the cytoplasm and occur in most cells, but especially abundant in SER. The tubules, the last one, the tubules are branched structure forming the reticular system along with the cistern A and vesicles. They usually have a diameter of around 50 to 190 micrometer and occur almost in all cells. So tubular form of endoplasmic reticulum is often found in SER and is dynamic in nature. So it is associated with the membrane movements, fusion, fission between membranes of cytocavity network. So this is about the structure and the differences we can see here. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum, this one, and rough endoplasmic reticulum. So the smooth endoplasmic reticulum or the agranular endoplasmic reticulum. This type of endoplasmic reticulum possesses smooth walls, as you can see here, because the ribosomes are not studded on the membranes, or they are not attached, they are absent. The smooth type of endoplasmic reticulum occurs mostly in those cells which are involved in the metabolism of lipids, including steroids and glycogen. And examples are adipose cells, interstitial cells, glycogen storing cells of the liver, conduction fibers of the heart, spermatocytes and leukocytes. As here, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, no ribosomes, found near the cell membranes, originate from the rough ER. So they are present after the RER and mainly composed of tubules, as you can see here, and synthesize and store proteins and also lipids, and mainly present in lipid forming cells. Coming to the rough endoplasmic reticulum, it possesses the rough walls because of the ribosomes which are remain attached to its membrane. So these ribosomes are specific transmembrane glycoproteins called as ribofurins 1 and 2 to which are attached the ribosomes while engaged in polypeptide synthesis. The rough type of endoplasmic reticulum is found abundantly in those cells which are active in protein synthesis, such as pancreatic cells, plasma cells, goblet cells and liver cells. So as we see here, they are found abundantly in the cytoplasm of most cells and they originate from the nuclear membrane. So they are the ones which connect the and form continuous with the nuclear membranes, and they are mainly composed of cistern A, that is sac-like structures, and synthesize and store lipids and also store proteins both. So mainly present in protein forming cells like pancreatic cells, as I said, or even plasma cells are the examples for the rough endoplasmic reticulum abundance. Now coming to the functions of endoplasmic reticulum, which include the first one, function of smooth ER include lipid metabolism. That is both catabolism and anabolism. They synthesize a variety of phospholipids, cholesterol and steroids. Glycogenolysis, that is the degradation of glycogen and the glycogen being polymerized in the cytoplasm. Drug detoxification by the help of cytochrome P450, which is abundant in the liver. So the endoplasmic reticulum play a role in drug detoxification. The endoplasmic reticulum provides an ultrastructural skeletal framework to the cells and gives mechanical support to the colloidal cytoplasmic matrix. The exchange of molecules by the process of osmosis, diffusion and active transports, all these processes, both passive and active transports, can happen through membranes of the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is also the main component of the endomembrane system. They are also called a cytoplasmic vacuolar system or cytocavity network. The endoplasmic reticulum contains many enzymes that perform various synthetic and metabolic activities, and the endoplasmic reticulum also provides an increased surface for various enzymatic activities. So the ER acts as an intracellular circulatory or transporting system. So they kind of cargo recruiting systems here. And as a growing secretory polypeptide emerges from the ribosomes, which from the RER, it passes through the RER membrane and gets accumulated in the lumen of RER. So here the polypeptide chains undergo tailoring or post-translational modifications, maturation and molecular folding to form functional secondary or tertiary protein molecules. So the RER pinches off certain tiny proteins filled vesicles which ultimately get fused with the cis Golgi. So that is, the RER pinches off the protein filled vesicles which are supposed to be targeted to the particular part of the cell would first go to the Golgi, that is the cis part of the Golgi, and Golgi later, along with certain proteins which are recruited for the directional transportation, will pass the protein and cargo it to its destination. The endoplasmic membranes are found to conduct intracellular impulses. Intracellular impulses. For example, the sarcoplasmic reticulum transmits impulses from the surface membrane into the deep region of the muscle fiber. So that ER would play a role because they act as a major component in storing the calcium and releasing episodically, in playing a role in depolarizing the cells. The ER membranes form a new nuclear envelope after each nuclear division. So the SER contains several enzymes, key enzymes that catalyze the synthesis of cholesterol, which is also a precursor substances for biosynthesis of two types of compounds, that is the steroid hormones and bile acids. So cholesterol synthesis is also seen in smooth endoplasmic reticulum, whereas the rough endoplasmic reticulum, proteins and glycoproteins which are co-translationally inserted into the rough endoplasmic membranes. Thus the endoplasmic reticulum is the site of the biogenesis of cellular membranes. So these are the 14 points related to the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Thank you very much for your patience listening. Any doubts, you can leave a message in the comment box or you can reach me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you very much.